What double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Munster. Shalom to the wandered Israelites, which include Judah's children, the so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Indians, who are oppressed together according to Jeremiah 50 and 33. But to whom pertaineth the adoption, the giving of the law, the promises, the glory, and the covenants according to Romans chapter 9? As you should know, opposed to the following teachings, which according to Revelation 14 and 4, represented defilement by foreign women. May the kingdom of everlasting life and joy, the secrets be revealed unto you, as a blood descendants of Jacob, whose name was later changed to Israel, according to Genesis 32 and 28, scattered to the four winds of the earth. Alright, as a people first, of course. We restored, alright, and this is really a quick lesson. Ecclesiasticus 3 and 18. The greater thou art, the more humble thyself, and thou shalt find favor before Yahweh. Not before man, alright, but before Yahweh. Because if you humble yourself in this world, people will think you are outsider, alright, you are nobody, alright, you are outcast, basically, right? Especially in these coming times, alright? But what does the word humble mean, okay? What does it mean, man? Alright, we will go into real quick. You see? You know, alright? To the idea of looking down or probing, to depress literally or figuratively, transitive or intransitive in various applications, is sort of a self-afflict answer by mistake. Okay, what's this? Okay. You know, Kahn did something different here. Okay. Attention, alright. Answer. So basically, chasten self, deal hardly with, defile, exercise, force, gentleness, humble, self, hurt, ravish, sing, by mistake for, okay, another word again, and another word, okay, submit self, weaken in any wise, okay? Submit self, weaken in any wise. Alright? Weaken, okay? Chasten self, deal hardly with. With what? With yourself, alright? Okay? You see? To be occupied, be busied with. To afflict, alright, are we not afflicted? Oppress, humble, be afflicted, be bowed down. And Yahweh got something to humble you, because we got so, you know, we got so much knowledge, basically, alright, you know, not because of our own understanding and our own well-doing and righteousness, you know, of course, because we study. Alright, that's also a part of show yourself approved to study, so you will receive knowledge and you will get deliverance. That's for sure, but again, only to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone. Alright, you know, we got that knowledge, alright, okay, you see? Okay. Become low. Make yourself low, man. If you're great, if you think you're great, make yourself low. Alright, because that's your true greatness, man. Alright, and it will be rewarded by Yahweh Barashem Yahweh Shai. Alright, before you even can see it. To be depressed, be downcast, to be afflicted, to stoop, to humble oneself, bow down, to be afflicted, be humble, to humble, mishandle, afflict, to be humiliated, alright. Humility before honor, alright. To afflict, to humble, weaken oneself, okay. Okay. Because everything else, man, alright, is basically in vain, okay. There is no praise of man, what we're looking for, alright, there is no even praising the brothers, alright, or, you know, being, you know, posting no scriptures, but always talking about, can't, shalom, 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 alright, you know, aman, alright, you know, put some scriptures out there and do the work, man, alright, so you will not have time that much to comment other brothers' videos, man. Alright, that's also in vain, that's also idolatry, alright, because idolatry has many different faces, alright. Philippians 3 and 8, ye are doubtless, and I count all things, some things, nah man, all things, alright, but loss for the excellency, alright, for the excellency, you see, to be superior, better than, alright, to surpass, alright, to have or hold over one, alright, superiority, better, higher, past, supreme, alright, the kingdom is supreme, man, hypercho, alright, compared to the Blue Letter Bible, I can't play this, but you would say it like hypercho or something, because it's Greek, alright, or something like that. But you have the Greek word here. Excellency of the knowledge of Yahawashai, my Lord, Kyrios in the Greek tongue, and in the Hebrew tongue, Yahweh. Alright. Why Yahawashai, his son? Alright. He to whom a person or thing belongs, about which he has the power of deciding, Master Lord, our Master. You see? Yahawashai is our master, for whom I have suffered the loss of all things. You see, alright, we are already in the suffering, alright, and we will basically suffer till Yahawashai comes back. And to count them but dung, you see, and what is dung, man? Okay, there was an error, Lord, in your request. Try again. Dung, skibalon, any refuse as the excrement of animals, of scourings, rubbish, tracks of things worthless and detestable. Okay, skibalon. You see? So basically, there's even a scripture that talks about a brother, a sister that falls out from the truth at this point of time, alright, even. You have it, alright. It's like a dog that goes back to his own dung, man. Not dung, alright. His own, alright. We have, I believe, many different English words for that. Of course, you know, you have many English words for one word, basically. You know, it's all hidden tongue, man. Alright. Vomit, okay. Vomit, alright. So a dog that returns to his own vomit, alright, that's these brothers and sisters that fall out, alright. And it's even possible in this later days, man, alright. You don't believe me, just check it out, alright. Nah, man, alright. Suffered the loss of all things and to count them but dung, that I may win Yahawashai. Alright, again, Christos in the hidden tongue, which is Yahawashai, the Messiah, the Anointed One. Alright, HaMashiach in Hebrew. Alright, which means the Anointed. Ha, the Anointed Mashiach. Okay. So you would say, like, he's the new high priest, man. Alright, and we're all priests now, man. Alright. Okay, but he is basically the priest who even, you know, gives Yahweh basically the prayers, alright, that we basically send out them, alright, because he will not hear you if you are healing, but he will hear you if what, alright, if you look for that, alright, for that, supreme kingdom, then, alright, you see, Romans 12 and 1, I beseech you, therefore, alright, to call to one side, call for the man, alright, as the man you Achaean man, alright, to address, I address you Achaean, speak to the Achaean, and to the Agraph, of course, alright, under the correct, you know, household order of your man, alright, you know, he will teach you basically, not me basically, okay? But they're also single women, of course. Therefore, Achaean, alright, Adelphos in the Greek, a brother, born of the same two parents or only of the same father or mother, having the same national ancestor. Oh, what's that? Okay, having the same national ancestor. Okay. So, that's actually interesting, because we have the same ancestor, that makes us one nation, that makes us Hebrew Israelites, and there is no other people in the Bible, but the people who go back to an ancestor, who is yet Jacob, whose name was later changed to Israel, according to what I said at the beginning. So even the Greek shows you that here, by the mercies of Alahayim, alright, Theos in the Greek, which means a god, a general name of deities, or the divinities, God the Father, alright, not Trinity, alright, we exposed that, but again, this is only a hidden website, alright, and you have many different wrong things here, okay? For example, Christ, Trinity, okay, what we saw today, that you present your bodies as a living sacrifice, again in the Greek, thysia, a sacrifice, victim, alright, even a victim to yourself, because you have to humble yourself, and as the Achaean always say also, your worst enemy, guess what, man, it is you, man, it is you, man, holy, acceptable. What means holy in the Greek, actually? We know it in the Hebrew. Means separated, just as we can read it in the Torah. I separated you from all the people on the earth, which means you are a holy people unto me, which means you are separated people unto me, for the people who can actually understand Hebrew sayings in the law. All right, that means that, and in the Greek it's hagios. And it means most holy thing, a saint. And who are the saints? Hebrew Israelites. Acceptable unto Alahayim, which is your reasonable service. See? Your service. That's your service. Service rendered for hire. Ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you to bring forth fruit. So nobody can choose Yahweh, he has to choose you. Many are called, but few are chosen. You don't know if you are chosen, because there are only a few that will get saved. The service and worship of Alahayim. What did I say at the beginning? The giving of the law, the promises, the blessings. Did I say the blessings? No, I think not. But the promises, which contains the blessings. The giving of the law, the glory you see. And I even believe that there was a word about the covenants, of course, but also the service, I believe, all right? You see? Basically the worship government, all right? The worship service, all right? The worship ministration, all right? All right? Perform sacred services. Can't, because it's sacred, and only Hebrew Israelites can do that. Back then, of course, you know, the you know, Aaron's lineage, of course, you know, you had the priests, all right, but today we have Yahweh Shai, that's our high priest again, all right. There's no Aaron, okay, no lineage of Aaron. Today to perform sacrifices. But we still go by basically the Levitical law, alright? Not because we bring sacrifices, because all the sacrifices are basically done to Yahweh Shai, but because we keep the laws to the best of our ability. Alright? Alright? You know, and for this, you know, you know, we will close it out here, alright, deliver it by faith, alright, okay, real quick, alright, and real short, you know, said, deliver it by faith, man, alright, but guess what, you have to deny yourself, alright, he who does not, you see, is not worthy of me. Matthew 10:38, and he that taketh not his cross and followeth after me is not worthy of me. He that loveth father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. And we pass away out of the world as grasshoppers, and our life is a tarnishment and fear, and we are not worthy to obtain mercy. But he that knew not and did commit things worthy of stripes shall be beaten with few stripes. For unto whomsoever much is given, of him shall be much required. And to whom men have committed much, of him they will ask the more. Okay, so we know that we are delivered by faith. Alright. You know. But with that, all praises to Yahweh, Baruch Hashem, Yahweh Shai, Baruch Hashem, Mekar Kodash. Alright, double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone. Alright, shalom, and see you in the next lesson, hopefully. Alright, God willing. Shalom.